Good afternoon. This is Todd Colvin coming to you from the floor of the CME Group. We are talking metals and gold. 1300, the level. We got there on Friday. We got above it, and it looked like smooth sailing, although an afternoon pullback saw some profit taking, maybe some calmer heads prevail, and gold dipped down back below 1300, which means that on Monday, today, typically we see that sell-off continue further if there's really no evidence of some kind of rising risk or turmoil around the world or something. And it didn't. Gold firmed, and we got down as low as 1290, and we rallied back up and close to 1300 again, which means we're kind of sitting around waiting for something to happen. The gold trade has been really one that's moved fairly straight since the middle of July. If you go back to the beginning of the year, it's up about $140 since the beginning of the year. So gold has been trending higher, but it's really made a big move since middle of July. And if we look at the dollar, what did the dollar do? Well, the dollar and gold were kind of doing their own thing for a lot of the first part of this year, but lately it has been the dollar getting crushed and gold trading higher, which is the way historically they have traded. So the dollar right now, again, has continued its weakness, whether it's uncertainty in Washington, whether it's uncertainty about the Fed, has yet to really reveal itself. But certainly the sell-off in the dollar is going to help keep gold bid. And lastly, we're going to talk about Jackson Hole. That could be one of the reasons why the dollar is getting hit. If you look at Jackson Hole, we're going to hear from Fed Chair Yellen. We're going to hear from several other key central bank figures, and they're going to talk about whether it is removing stimulus, adding, staying the same, raising rates, trimming balance sheets. There's going to be a lot of balls up in the air that week, and it's going to headline with Janet Yellen on Friday and Mr. Mario Draghi on Friday afternoon. So those are the two speakers I think that are most anticipated. The conference begins on Thursday, goes to Saturday, and we'll highlight a number of different angles and a number of different central bankers. So right now, the market kind of waiting on pins and needles. If it's an aggressive hawkish outlook, you could see gold prices pull back pretty dramatically. However, the dollar and it trading against the basket of other currencies, we could see a dollar sell, could see a dollar bid. It all depends on who comes out on top when it comes to the currency bidding. So right now, gold looking stronger, a lot of risks out there, which could keep it north of 1300. The big level, if you go back to 2011 that we'll be looking at, the 2011 to 2017 midpoint is about 1480. So we're still well away from that, but that will be a level certainly we want to keep on the radar if we continue to creep higher. We are not even anywhere near that yet, but just wanted to throw that out there. So right now, gold still trending higher, but we have a key central bank meeting, global central bank meeting this Friday that will determine probably the next few weeks of trade. This has been Todd Colvin coming to you from the floor of the CME Group.